In this tutorial, we will discuss accessing DynamoDB database from your Lambda function. So previously in AWS, you could add DynamoDB as a destination by just clicking there and choosing DynamoDB here. But recently they have changed the architecture. It's no longer possible to add DynamoDB directly like this. So it has to be done through your code itself. Okay, so this is what my intention is. So as we mentioned before, we already have a Lambda handler which accepts our IoT message and converts it into Fahrenheit. So my intention is to store the timestamp, the original temperature in degrees Celsius, as well as the converted temperature into a table in DynamoDB. Okay, so there are different ways of doing it. I will explain one of the ways. So first, let's create a table where we will be storing this information. Let's just call it like my Lambda table. This we have discussed before. We need a primary key, and we are going to use the timestamp as a primary key because usually it has to be a unique attribute, and choose create. Now the table is created. Now let's come back to our code. Okay, so for accessing any other resource from your Lambda function, you will have to use the Python package called Boto3. So we'll be extensively using this package in the future tutorials also. So first you need to import it, Boto3. This is Amazon's SDK, they call it. As far as Python is concerned, this is like a package. Now the first step is to create an object here. We call it client, and we call Boto3.client followed by DynamoDB. Okay. Again, this step, similar step, we'll be using in future also. So depending upon what kind of service you want to use, you will be creating a client of that type. So we want to use DynamoDB, so we created a client of type DynamoDB. If you want to use SNS, you will be using an SNS client, so on and so forth. Okay, now let's look at the documentation for Boto3. So Boto3, let's search for DynamoDB. So here you will be able to see all the methods available in DynamoDB. Okay, so we are going to use client, and here you can see all these are the methods for DynamoDB Boto3 client. Okay, so you can read the details. You can see a lot of functions are there. For example, there's a function to create a table from your Lambda itself. But in our case, we have already created a table. We just want to store some item there. If you want to store any item to an existing table, we'll have to use the putItem method. Okay, so let's look at the syntax for putItem. And here you can see the syntax for different languages. And we'll be using Python. And this is the syntax for putItem in Python. And this is how AWS documentation will write the syntax. So basically, you need to use putItem method. You need an argument called table name. That is a mandatory argument. So here you can see the explanation, and the name of the table should be given as a string. For example, in our case, my table name is my Lambda table. So we'll be giving that as the table name, followed by the item. Okay. Now this is an example for one item, and you can have multiple items. So each item will represent one entry to the table. So it will be going into a particular column in the table, and if you look at it, you will see that is also following a JSON object format. Actually for Python, it is following a dictionary format. So you need to type item equal to, now the attribute name should be always string type, so that's what is written here. It should be string type, then within the curly bracket you can give the value. Okay, so again, if you want to store a string item, you need to write like this, followed by the value in string format. If you want to store a number, you need to write like this, followed by that number, but that number should be written within quotes. So basically, you will see everything has to be in string format for storing it. So this is a special JSON object. They call it DynamoDB JSON object. Okay, so when we write the example, it will be clear to you. So let's try it. So we already created. Now let's try to store it. Okay, so we need to use something equal to. The response that will be also coming in a JSON object format that you can see at the bottom how the response will look like. Here, this is how the response will look like if you want to check the response. And there you can actually find whether he successfully stored or what is the current capacity of the table, all those information. This example, we are not going to check the response. We just want to put something into the table and see whether it is working or not. Okay, so let me copy this response equal to this one. Okay, put our table name is this one. So let's copy that. And followed by the item. So item equals so each item should be given as a JSON object. Okay, so as far as we are concerned, our items are timestamp, the original temperature value, and the converted temperature value. Okay, so let's see here, item followed by the name of the attribute. So it is, let's call it timestamp itself, timestamp, followed by the value of that attribute. Here, so timestamp is a string, so we need to write s in quotes followed by the actual timestamp. So that timestamp we can get from this event. So let's do event of timestamp. Next, we'll store the original temperature. So let me call it temperature in degree Celsius, now followed by its event, its value. So again, as a JSON object. Now this temperature, we are storing it as a number, but remember, for DynamoDB, it should be still provided in string format. So the original temperature I can get by calling event of, here you can see event of temperature. That will give me the original temperature. But when you are storing it, it has to be converted into string format. So we convert it into string format using string function. So that's also done. Finally, I want to store the converter temperature also. Okay, so let's do this conversion before this. So let's call this temperature in Fahrenheit is again, it's a number type and it is a string of this converted value. And we need comma after each item. Okay, so this completes it. Maybe we can remove this one, and maybe we can just return 0. And remember to save everything and remember to test it before actual deployment. So we already have our event configured here. So we can just click test. And now you will see there is an error happening. So the error is not a syntax error. You can see it's an access denied exception. When calling the put item operator to so and so is not authorized to perform DynamoDB put item. Okay, so basically he's saying you do not have the authorization to write to DynamoDB. So this is coming because the role that I mentioned in the previous tutorial doesn't have access to DynamoDB. So this time I will have to briefly mention about the roles. Okay, so to mention about role, we need to choose another service from Amazon called the Identity and Access Management, IAM. So I'm logging into my IAM console. So IAM, this is another service from Amazon. We will discuss it in detail later, but let me give you the brief idea. So IAM is the service which is managing all the security regarding your access. Okay, this is the one who is making sure the people who are accessing your account, they have valid credential. They also manage your policy. That means when one or more services communicate with each other, you make sure one particular service is authorized to access another service, etc. So that we'll discuss in detail in the future. Now, if you go here, roles, you can see already a lot of roles are there. Okay, so if you remember this thing, my function role, okay, this role we actually created from Lambda when we started our project here. Okay, that is this role. These roles we created from our IoT when we created some policies to write to DynamoDB and to write to Lambda. Okay, although we have created them from IoT core as well as Lambda, they are actually got created inside the IAM service, and he is the one who is managing it. So now we need to create a new role which can access DynamoDB, not only access, which can write to DynamoDB from Lambda. Our current role is this one. If you come to basic settings, our current role is this one, my function role, and this is a minimal function role. And you can see like what he can basically do. He can upload logs to CloudWatch. Okay, because he has access to CloudWatch, we were able to do print operations to CloudWatch before. That's his only access level. He is authorized to access only CloudWatch. If you want to do anything more, we need to choose a different role. And that role, you cannot directly create from this pre-existing templates. There are some templates here, but none of these templates will enable you to write to DynamoDB. There are roles which can read from DynamoDB, but if you want to write to DynamoDB, that cannot be directly generated from here. We'll have to come to IAM console and do it from here. So in the future, again, we'll extensively use IAM, then I will give you more idea. So for the time being, let me just choose create a role, and we need a role from Lambda, so I can choose Lambda, and here you can set the permission. So the permission that I basically need is a write permission to DynamoDB. So you can search for DynamoDB and he will give you all the possible policy. Again, Amazon, they will suggest you to choose the bare minimal policy to make sure there are no unauthorized access. But for the time being, let me choose the simplest one, Amazon DynamoDB full access. That means if you expand it, it will show all the access levels. You can do everything for DynamoDB, full access. You can read, write, create table, everything with this particular role. Okay, so that's the one I am choosing. Create next. These are optional. And here, let me give a name. My Lambda DynamoDB role, and let me create this new role. Now, once you create this role, if you come back to Lambda and choose existing role, just do a refresh, and that will be listed here, my Lambda DynamoDB role, and save it. So you have changed your role now. Now let's retest, and now it is successful because now you have access. Now if you come back to my DynamoDB, go to item, you can see the item is there. This is coming from our test data. If you remember, timestamp and temperature, these values came from here, but this one is the converted one, right? Now if you click this item, you can see the JSON representation. Okay, this is the actual JSON representation. These are two numbers. This is a string. But if you choose DynamoDB JSON, this is the one. Okay, but this is the one we actually send from Lambda to DynamoDB. And here you can see even numbers, they are treated as strings. And these prefixes basically tells the type of the data here, and then he will convert it into actual JSON and store it. Why Amazon is doing like that, that is their discretion. We have no say, but we have to basically follow what are they asking to do. Okay, so everything is working now. Since we tested, since everything is working, now we can run our actual IoT code, publisher code, and see whether things are still working. So Python publisher. You can see now data is going. Let's come to our table here and just keep refreshing, and you can see the data is getting updated. Okay. Now this method is much flexible than our previous method of writing to DynamoDB, because previously your entire payload will be coming as a single item, and you can have one key and one sort key. That's it. But if you follow this one, you can have any number of columns, and you can separate your data into multiple columns very easily. Okay. Now this can be done without going through Lambda also. You can directly send from your computer the data to the DynamoDB using Boto3, and you can achieve the same result that we may discuss in the future. But the main circumstance where we use this technique is you send your IoT data to the cloud and you do processing in the cloud. You apply whatever analytics or algorithm you want to use, and after that you want to store the process data in the table. Okay, that is where this is more useful. So in the next tutorial, similar thing, I will discuss how we can use SNS and we can send email or SMS directly from your Lambda function. See you.